Bigby!
Snow?
Come with me.
Snow. Snow!
What? Sorry, I'm... What is it?
What happened?
I just can't get into it this second. We need to hurry to...
Hi.
Hello. Good morning. Or evening.
Yeah.
These walls are paper thin. We need to be careful. We'll talk outside. This girl? Is... She's not a Mundy, right? Who was she? I thought I knew everyone in Fabletown. She looks familiar.
Just a... girl. We didn't have a whole lot of time to chat. The woodsman. He attacked her and I stepped in. And he threatened to kill us both.
No, you don't think he...
I don't think anything yet. Just give me a second.
It's just... terrible.
So, did you see anyone else?
No, no one.
No cabs, no voices, Mundys?
Maybe, but... no, I don't think so. I would remember.
Okay.
Big P, did one of us... do this?
There hasn't been a murder in Fabletown in a long time.
All the more reason we shouldn't start a panic before we know what's going on. I'll have a look around. We don't have much time before people will be coming through here.
It's her ribbon. There's some kind of symbol here.
Huh. I don't recognize it.
Neither do I. She was placed here with some care.
What do you mean?
You can see that someone didn't just toss her here. She was deliberately placed for us to find.
What kind of monster would do this?
Strange cut. What did this to her?
What could do something like that?
Either something very sharp, or something with magic attached to it.
I'm sorry. This is just... so surreal. What do you want to do next?
We still have some time. I should keep investigating the area.
Okay, good idea.
blood. Drops of blood. I'd say it's been here an hour, maybe? No signs that it's been here long. Fabric. Looks like jeans. Doesn't tell me much. Just some loose trash. Yep, more blood. Someone might have hopped the fence, got caught, and left the trail I found earlier. Blood. Still wet. Sharp enough.
What are you doing?
Better to be thorough.
Sure, just hurry up. We don't have much time. We should move her before anyone shows up. We'll find out more at the business office. She'll be in the books. I'm sure of it. Bigby, do you have any idea what's going on? How did this happen? Why her?
Sorry, Snow. Just not ready to say yet.
Fine. Let's just get upstairs. I'm gonna have to tell Crane about this. As long as King Cole is gone, he's acting mayor. He needs to know. And he's going to find out anyway, so we may as well get out in front of it. It'll just be worse if he finds out we held it from him.
We should wait until we have more to tell him. Right now, all we know is a girl is dead. Telling Crane doesn't change that, and I've got all the motivation I need to find out who did this.
That sounds reasonable, but I don't know. I'll think about it.
I just don't want him interfering.
Crane's not what's important right now. We need to figure out who this girl was so we can find whoever did this. Take this back to Dr. Swinehart. He can take a look at it. I'll meet you at the business office.
What are you, blind? Why, you don't see there's a line? I've been standing here a half hour already. You get to just walk in? Must be nice being the sheriff. Do whatever the fuck you like.
I work here.
And what great work you do, sheriff.
That didn't feel very genuine.
Fucker.
Because you are the one bringing this to me, Miss Snow. The one who so simply stumbled upon this catastrophe on our very doorstep. The last thing I need with Mayor Cole away is a hysteria. Do you understand me?
Yes, of course I do.
Don't interrupt me, Miss Snow.
You asked me a question.
Don't change the subject. You are to blame for this unpleasantness, Miss Snow.
I brought you this news as soon as I could.
You are trusted to keep things running smoothly around here. This is a disaster.
It isn't anyone's fault. Instead of trying to assign blame, maybe we should figure out how to catch the fucker who did this.
Oh, is that how you see things? Sheriff, you are the one charged with protecting the citizens of Fabletown. Your failure to do so cost someone their life and the safety of the entire community. Tell me you've been doing something. Are there any leads? Suspects? Anything. Anything at all. Any shred of evidence you two know what the hell you're doing. Because right now, I have half a mind to fire the both of you.
The woodsman is a person of interest. From what we've been able to gather, he was last seen with the victim.
The woodsman? That drunk wretch was the cause of this?
It's a lead. Nothing certain yet.
Well, find him. Get him in here if that's all you have to go on.
You two need to get a handle on this situation quickly and quietly.
The last thing we need is all of Fabletown knowing there's a killer amongst us. Snow.
Yes? Sir?
Call Vivian right this minute and let her know I'm coming in early for my massage.
I will.
Where is the bottle of wine you were to purchase? Don't bother. Forget it. Can't do anything right.
Do your job, Sheriff. Or we'll find someone who can.
You would have just pissed him off more.
All right.
Well, that could have gone better. Well, I guess I should have listened to you and waited.
Wasn't gonna say I told you so.
You don't have to say it. It would have been better to have more to offer. Get our ducks in a row. Oh, Crane doesn't like people smoking and... Never mind. Smoke away.
What an asshole.
Yep. That was about an 8 on the asshole scale. Asshole scale? Well, that doesn't sound right.
Is he gone?
Yes, thankfully. Buffkin!
Hello, Miss Snow.
Drinking? This early? Where did you get that?
It was by Mr. Ichabod's desk.
Then don't you think it probably belongs to him?
Maybe. How are you today, Mr. Bigby?
It hasn't been a great morning, Buffkin.
Sorry.
Not your fault. Thanks for asking, though.
Buffkin, get the books.
Which books?
The ones with all the fables in it.
Not sure that was any more specific.
Bring the first 3.
Be back in a few minutes.
He knows the ones I'm talking about. There's bound to be information on her here. Somewhere. We'll at least be able to get her real name from the books whenever Buffkin finds them. In the meantime, poke around. Maybe the mirror can help. I really have to get this appointment squared away, but let me know if you need anything.
Hello, Vivian? Hi, this is Snow White, Mr. Crane's assistant.
Magic lamps are pretty much just lamps, after the genie's been freed.
Yes, that's right.
Hey, Magic Mirror. I got a question.
You know the rule.
I don't have time for this shit.
Your impatience is callow. You're needlessly cruel. But have some respect for our history rules.
Mirror, mirror. If you're able, tell me all about this fable.
See? Was that so hard?
Yeah, I'm about 2 seconds away from kicking a hole in you.
There's no need for that. Fine. Of which fable do you wish to know?
I don't know her name. Not yet, anyway.
Well, until you do, I can't help you.
Show me the woodsman. Where is he?
What you see is complete. The woodsman stumbles down a street.
No shit. Which street?
I'm sorry, Bigby. I can only show you what can be seen.
Show me Snow White.
Not much of a request. She's in this very room.
Show me Bufkin.
Hey! Put down the bottle and get to work.
Still looking!
Show me the woodsman. Nobody right now.
Very well. Please return should you wish to ask about someone else. Or someone new.
Well, I'm sure we'll get it all cleared up. Okay. Thank you.
Strength. I guess it comes in all forms.
We'll start with these. Any information on fables in our community will be somewhere in these books.
Beauty in happier days. I think her name was Red. She didn't make it out. Beast. Colin and his brothers. I've seen this before. This symbol on the man's clothes, it's the same as the rings.
Could be her father or husband. This has most of the emblems of the old days, and usually what family they come from. If it's in here, we'll have her name.
Ah, great.
What?
I can't read any of this shit.
I can help.
Yeah, thanks.
We look out for each other.
Don't overdo it. Bufkin, translate.
An exquisite design from the good china of Toad Hall.
Mr. Toad?
He probably wrote this in himself.
This is the one. Where is this symbol from? Which family or story?
That's an odd one. Family name? Alelairo? I'll go look it up.
Alelairo? That means every kind of fur in German.
Donkey skin?
Yes. What does it say?
Donkey skin girl, also known as donkey skin. Also known as... ass skin. prefers to go by the name Faith. Poetic?
Bufkin, we don't need the commentary.
The story of donkey skin. There was once a great king with a beautiful queen. The queen grew ill and had her husband promise to only marry the most beautiful girl in the kingdom. After a long search, it became clear that the only woman in the land that could match her beauty was... his daughter, Faith. She had a magic cloak made from the skin of her father's prized donkey that would hide her beauty so she could escape his kingdom. Eventually, she married a prince who could see past the magic cloak and knew her true beauty. And they lived happily ever after. Should I mark it, Miss Snow?
Yes. Please.
And what's her husband's name?
Lawrence. Prince Lawrence.
We got what we came for.
Yeah.
Her name's Faith. She was married to Prince Lawrence. I mean, that's more than
her name was Faith.
Yeah.
We should talk to the husband.
You think he did it?
With this sort of thing, it's usually the person who knew them best.
Or it's someone completely random.
Mirror, mirror, blah, blah, able, blah, blah, blah about this fable.
Of which fable do you wish to know?
He's a prince, I think. Show me Prince Lawrence. What's he been doing? Where is this?
Where's what?
Do you know where Prince Lawrence lives?
If he's a prince, probably relocated in the South Bronx. Yellow building, red window shutters.
Red frames.
Yep, that's the one. I can take us there.
Show me Faith's father, the old king. Guess that crosses him off the suspect list. Show me Faith.
Through powerful magic, her whereabouts concealed. Unfortunately for you, these lips are sealed.
What?
These lips are sealed. It's not my choice of phrasing, Bigby. It's simply the way this has to be.
Nobody right now.
Anything we can use?
Yeah, that'll have to do for now.
Come on, we're going over there. Sorry, I have to get that. Hello, Woodland's business office. Yes, he is. Hold on. Bigby, it's for you.
Bigby, it's me, Toad. You there?
What do you want?
Bigby, shit. Listen, right, there's a bloke upstairs going through all the woodsman's things. Get over here, Bigby, before he... Oh, wait, hang on. Oi, shit. Hey!
What was that about?
Hard to say. Something going on over at Toad's place.
What about Faith's husband?
I don't know, I couldn't really tell. But he could be in trouble. And we should go there anyway to search her apartment. Toad might have to wait.
Whenever you're ready. Did Toad say who was there? Was it the woodsman?
I don't know. It's possible. Whoever it was, it didn't seem like Toad was happy to see him.
Well, maybe Prince Lawrence can wait.
Yeah, he didn't see him. He could use some help, too.
Well, where to first?
Bigby! Shit! Listen, right? There's a bloke upstairs going through all the woodsman's things.
You think he did it? What's her husband's name?
Lawrence. Prince Lawrence.